So I have written like this, and now we can write that this thing, just replacing, if we write it in the form of L prime, or if we write in the form of L is L prime. So we can write with no worries here that AL is basically equal to, just move it here. So it will be 2L plus 1, 2L plus 1 over 2, and it will be R to the power L. An integration from 0 to pi and v naught of theta, and this will be pl cos of theta and sine of theta in d theta. So this will be equal to this thing. So al, unless, means we have found al. Now we can put this AL here in this one, AL here, and then PL of cos theta. So it is basically the solution of this equation. But if in case V naught of theta is being specified, that what's the value of V naught of theta, then we can calculate this integral and we can find AL, and then we can write the final solution. Let's say in this example, finally, we are being given with the value of v naught theta, and this is equal to k sine square in theta by 2. This is the value of potential specified on the surface of this sphere, if for example, then we can calculate AL. So AL in this situation is then equal to 2L plus 1 by 2 and R to the power L, and then from 0 to pi we can do a certain trick here in order to reduce this thing, into the, we can reduce our equation here. So it will be something like this, that p naught means I reduce it into p naught in p1, so I can then finally write that what are the values of this thing. So here let me rewrite this thing. If I do use this one, like V naught of theta, let me write V naught of theta here, V naught of theta. This is equal to K and sine square theta by 2. I can write in the form of half angle formula. So sine square theta by 2 I can write is 1 minus cos theta by 2. So it will be 2 here, and this will be 1 minus cos theta. Sine square theta by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos theta by 2. We can utilize the sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, replacing theta by 2, we can do this thing. Or if we write cos of 2 theta equal to theta identity, and then replacing theta by 2, so it will become cos theta, and I hope you will be able to do this conversion quickly. Now here, if I look at this one, means what I wanted to introduce here, as I told written earlier about the polynomials here. So this one is 1, and 1 is basically p naught of cos theta. So I can write that this is k over 2, and this one is p naught of cos theta, and minus cos theta, our x was equal to p1 of cos theta, so this is p1 of cos theta, and here it is. I have just converted it into the Legendre polynomials. Now if I put this equation back into the equation where I'm having the 3.6 equation, if I put it there, then I don't need to even find this integral, because this integral I will have to put V naught of theta, then PL prime of this, and I will have to again solve the equation. But now is the potential I have converted into this one, so it's better I go to this equation, which is V R of theta, and this is equation 3.67. So I will go to the 3.67 equation. Now we are having V naught of theta equal to this thing, and here in this equation V naught of theta is equal to this. So we compare both the equations and we will have that V naught of theta is equal here. If I go here, then if I look here, then I see that L is 0 and 1 here in my potential. So I will have to go to two terms only in this expansion. So I can write that it will be A 0 and R to the power 0 and P 0 of cos theta plus the next term A1 and R to the power 1 and P1 of cos theta. Then this thing is equal to V0 of theta, and V0 of theta here I am having K over 2 multiplied with P0 cos of theta and minus K over 2 and P1 cos of theta. Now from here I can determine the values of A0 and A1 here. This implies that A0 here in R power 0 is 1, so we are having A0 multiplied with P0 cos of theta, and then we are having plus A1 and R to the power 1, so it is R and P1 cos of theta. This is equal to this thing, K over 2 P0 cos theta. So it means that A0 is equal to K over 2, while A1 is equal to K over 2 R. So we got the values of A1 equal to A0 value we got is K over 2, and the value of A1 and the value of A1 is equal, it's minus K over 2 minus K over 2, and R will come from here, so minus K over 2 R. So I have determined the value of A0 in A1, and this was the job which is to be done. So I can now come back to this equation, and this will give me V of R theta. So this implies that V of R theta here now in this example, only two polynomials are sufficient, and this is equal to A0 R to the power this, A0 R to the power 0 and PL, so it will be P0 cos of theta plus A1 and R to the power 1 P1 of cos theta. So this is equal, A0 is equal to K over 2, and what about P0 cos of theta? So P naught cos of theta is equal to 1 plus A1 is equal to minus K over 2R, and then R, and P1 cos of theta is equal to cos theta. So I can simplify this one. This implies that V R of theta is equal to, if I take K over 2 is common, then this will be K over 2 and 1 minus R over R and cos of theta. Look here, that V naught R of theta equal to this thing, and this is our final solution. When I reach the surface of the sphere R equal R, then this is cancelled and we will have 1 minus cos theta, and K over 2 1 minus cos theta is basically the potential, and it will convert into V naught of theta. So we got the solution right here by just finding these things. Similarly, there are two more problems, and out of not two but three more problems, we are having 3.7, we are having 3.8, and we are having 3.9. So we will solve those examples as well, and this will move us, means this will boost our confidence how to solve problems based on the very simplified solution, and the things are quite easier in this form compared to the previous one, in which we are considering some vectorial geometry and then applying laws of cosines and finding the potential inside and outside of the sphere. So in the next example, we are interested to find the potential outside the sphere.